Hello everyone, it's tax time. It's time to get some money back into your account. So this video is going to be a step-by-step guide on how you can lodge your tax return all by yourself. And I will also share some tips on how you can maximize the return you get, so make sure you watch till the end. So if it's your first time filing a tax return, don't worry. It's a super easy process and I'll be guiding you through every step. Before I start, I want to tell you all that this video is not financial advice and this is only meant for education purposes. Do not consider this video as a financial advice. So before you can lodge your tax return, the one thing you will need is a MyGov account. You need a MyGov account to access the Australian Taxation Office and lodge your tax return. So to sign up for a MyGov account, you have to visit my.gov.au and then click on Create a MyGov account button. It's a very easy process which involves you entering some basic information like your name, address, phone number, etc. And once you have entered all of that, you're good to go. I already have a MyGov account, so I'll just log into it. For security purposes, you get a login code on your mobile phone, and once you've entered that code, you can now access your MyGov account. So step two. Now you need to link your Australian Taxation Office with your MyGov. To link your Australian Taxation Office into MyGov, scroll down to My Services and then click on Link a Service. After clicking on Link a Service, select the Australian Taxation Office and follow the steps. I won't be going into details on how you can link your ATO with MyGov, but if you still need help, I have linked a video in the description which is a step-by-step guide on how you can link ATO to your MyGov. So once ATO is linked with your MyGov, you'll be able to see ATO under your services. Go ahead and open it. So once you open the ATO website, you should automatically see the tax return for the last financial year under Actions. If you don't see it there, don't worry. Scroll down, click on Manage Tax Returns, Not Lodged, and then Prepare. First, it will prompt you to check all your contact details. If everything is fine, just press Next. Next thing is to check your bank details. Make sure that these details are correct because this is where you will get the money and you don't want your money to be going into some random person's account. The next step is personalizing your tax return. Here you choose the options which are relevant to you. The first thing it asks you is that if you are an Australian resident for tax purposes. Normally, if you've lived and worked in Australia for more than 6 months, then you should be a resident. If you are unsure, then use this tool, answer a few simple questions, and it should tell you if you are a resident for tax purposes. The next step is to select your sources of income for the last financial year. The system should have automatically selected the options which are relevant to you, but I recommend you still go over them and make sure everything is correct. So once you have declared all your income sources, so the next thing you want to do is claim deductions. Now, for those of you who don't know what deductions are, deductions are simply things which you can claim from your tax and therefore decreasing your tax liability and increasing your tax refund. So normally you will just be selecting the work-related expenses, but if you have made a donation, gifted something which comes under a tax deductible bracket, then you can select that as well. If you have earned any income in the last financial year using Uber Eats, Deliveroo or any other online service, then do include it in your tax return. So our final step, step four, it's preparing your tax return. So up until now you have told ATO that how you earned your income and what you will be deducting, but now is the time to fill in those figures. Let's click on the income section first. All your incomes from the last financial year will be listed here. If all your incomes are green, that means they're tax ready and you don't need to do anything, you can just press save and continue. But if it's red and it says required, then these are the steps you need to follow. So what you need to do is get the last pay slip for the 2020-2021 financial year and then make sure the figures on your pay slip match the figures here. So once you've verified that all the income figures are correct, press yes under do you want to include this income. If these figures do not match your last pay slip, then change them accordingly. The second option is capital gains or losses. So if you've earned any income through investing in stocks, property, etc., make sure you list it here. And now it's time to get the money back. That is the deductions. Just a friendly reminder, do not claim the things you've not spent money on or which is not relevant to you, because if ATO checks and verifies, then you can face a heavy fine. Your major deductions will be work-related expenses like traveling expenses, your work-related uniforms, etc. I'll be claiming the car expenses here as I've used my personal vehicle to travel around for work purposes. I don't have a logbook for records, so I'll be using the cents per kilometer method. I've traveled more than 5,000 kilometers for work purposes, but the maximum you can claim using this method is 5,000, so I'll be doing that. My work also includes the use of protective clothing, so I can also claim cleaning expenses for those. As I do not have any receipts, the maximum I can claim for this is $300. So since the COVID pandemic began, I have worked from home, so I can also claim my working from home expenses, which covers electricity, gas, rent, etc. So ATO has a shortcut method on how much you can claim for work-related expenses for the last financial year. So that equates to 80 cents for every hour worked at home. That works out to be around $1,640 in my case. So that's everything what I can claim. So we'll just press continue. The last thing you need to do is select Medicare and private health insurance. So if you are an international student or someone who does not qualify for Medicare, then you can claim a reduction in Medicare, which you have already paid as part of the taxes. Select yes for the medical entitlement statement, and you can get it later if they ask for it. Just enter the number of days you're in Australia, the number of days you want to claim the Medicare exemption for. In my case, I was in Australia for 365 days, so that's what I'm going to enter. Once this is done, you're almost done with your tax return, and all you need to do is select the relevant options for the last two questions, and you'll see an option to calculate an estimate. You can click on this option and get an estimate of how much money you will be getting back. So once you have done everything, you can declare all the information is correct and then press save, and your tax return is now lodged. So once the return is lodged, you should get a confirmation email, and it usually takes up to 2 weeks to get the money into your account. Please hit that like button if you found the video helpful, and also consider subscribing to the channel, as I will be bringing lots of informative content in the near future. Leave a comment below if you have any questions regarding your tax return, and I'll be happy to help you guys.